Welcome to another Kinder MRT rescue video. In this one, we help a couple who've been camping overnight in Peternook Wood. She'd injured her ankle really badly sometime through the night, and from what we saw, it looked like it was probably broken. We pick this up as we're driving down a track, which brings us out at the top of Kinder Reservoir, and the stream in front of us kind of runs up from the reservoir through Peternook Wood and then eventually up to the downfall. If you like to see what we do, then please think about subscribing to the channel. It will keep you up to date with the latest videos as we release them.
So it's just gone lunchtime on a Sunday in October. Just had a call to come and try and see what's going on with a couple who have an ankle injury, which we think they actually sustained last night. I think they're wild camping, Looks like they had an accident at some point over the night. I think she's hurt her ankle really badly. Can't walk on it, so they can't get out. A couple of good things from our side. Firstly, they didn't call us last night, which would have meant we'd have spent our Saturday night doing this instead of a fairly pleasant Sunday afternoon. And the other side, I suppose, is that actually it's not that far for us. It's going to be a tricky stretch to carry, but it isn't all that far. It's in one of the kind of well-used wild camping spots, below where we did a stretcher carry recently from Mermaid's Pool. So this is almost an identical call out, except for it's a bit closer and it's a bit easier. So not too bad really. This is Peternook Wood we're coming up to. You can just about see Kinder Downfall in the mist above it. It's a really nice spot, but quite well used, and hopefully it should just be meet up with them. Dale will do some medical stuff, as he does, and we'll stretch them back to a Land Rover. That'll take them over the tops, get them back to a road, and hopefully we can hand them over to a land ambulance then. So one of our guys, Ian, was out. He's got a search dog, and he's training her out at Punkinder today, so he's gone straight there. I think he's already found her. So I think we're just about to catch up with them. So this should be them now, hopefully. So we're all good now. We've got to the CAS site. Dale and Ian in the blue, is our guy who was on the hill walking his dog. So Dale's currently looking at the casualty. She has got a badly damaged lower leg, so it's going to be a stretcher carry no matter what we do. We just walked across this stream to get in, so Steve's just having a look to see if there is a better point for us to go across with the stretcher. The vehicle is going to be on the other side, and this side of the stream is too steep. As we go further down there, we're going to have to come across and go down that path. So we're just trying to see if there's a better way out of here. Last time we did this, it was a lot drier, a lot less water in this stream. So if we do have to go across here, I think we're probably going to get very wet feet. But that's part of the job. Kinder 2 are just arriving, so they've come down in a different Land Rover. Brought in the stretcher. All we really need is a stretcher to get out of here. So they brought in the stretcher. It comes in two halves, as you can see, the two guys carrying it in. And we'll just watch them cross the stream. No, we need everybody out there. No, we're gonna cross down there. So the stretcher itself comes in two parts, and we fasten it together, and then we can drop the casualty onto it, carry her over this fence, and then carry her over the stream down there somewhere, and head back to the Land Rovers.
Before you do that, could you just confirm that Ian Burley has arrived at the CAS site? Over.
Yeah. Okay, hold. On you, Darren. John. Hold on. No, not yet. Yeah.
Yep. Clear.
Okay.
Get all the gear on you. Come on.
So we'll take it, Steve.
Yeah.
Ready? Me and you. Okay, bring it. I'm crossing round. Swing round. Okay, just back up slightly. When you're ready.
Thank you.